Before I really start, permit me to turn you into classroom children for a while. Now, and let's be very snappy and fast about this. If I ask you to identify the three main courses, not the three main courses of teacher-related courses of poor classroom performance of children. What are some of the things you'll be able to identify? Any volunteer? Let's just snap you up. Yes, sir? Three teacher-related.
Absenteeism,
yes. I said three, yes.
Lack of knowledge.
Yeah.
And poor teaching methods.
Right. Beautiful one there. Yes. Any other volunteer? Let's be quick about this. Three teacher-related causes of poor performance in classroom. Yes, Shuri?
Lack of preparation by the teacher.
Okay. Beautiful. Yes. Any other? Yes. Any volunteer to add? Yes.
Poor teacher-student relationship.
Okay. Yeah. Any other? Okay, we could go on mentioning, and the group coincidentally is also made up of people from different. In fact, we represent five different countries in our group, and I guess the issues that you are bringing up has to do with, you know, like we said, and in reality, issues that have to do with poor performance or teaching in classroom, and most of these issues are environmentally related. You know, what may pertain in one situation will not necessarily pertain in another situation. And as a group, one thing that was clear to all of us was that one of the issues, in addition to what you mentioned, was critical issues was the issue of teachers not being able to use teaching and learning materials in class. Yes, even if they use it, some instances you may see some making the effort to use it. But the question that comes up is, are they even relevant? Do the children even understand? Because sometimes by geographical description, some children, you may give them a TLM and the TLM will simply not make any sense to that child because it doesn't in any way represent what he knows, what we term as, you know, his relevant, previous knowledge. For example, you take a child from a part of Ghana, the child has never seen a sea, and you want to cite an example of a water body, and you go and cite an example of a sea. It doesn't make sense to that child. I think you all agree with me. So what we intend to do as a group, and having agreed on the topic of equipping teachers with the creative skills to develop teaching and learning materials from the environment, what we intend to do is actually to take these teachers through the training. So that, and our emphasis is not just creating teaching and learning environment, but we're talking about creating those materials using local resources. Why the emphasis on local resources? The reason is not far-fetched. Because local resources, when you ask teachers why they do not use TLMs, for example, I mean, everybody knows that it's the matter of convenience. They say it's easier to come to the classroom and talk, earn your lesson and go out without having to go through the laborious, you know, act of, you know, picking a TLM, interacting with the students. It's enjoyable, but it's very tedious. So they just said, oh, well, the school has not given us those TLMs. The school has not given us money to buy the TLMs. It's about money. But that should not be the issue. The issue is that there are a lot of resources lying in our garden. For example, if I take this container, this bottle of water, finish drinking it, I can gather a number of these things and they become counters. I don't need to buy these in the market. I can take this bottle and cut it into another shape and teach a concept. I don't need to buy this. So this is the kind of conscientization that we want to give to our teachers. And so as we go back to our respective countries, to our respective working places, what we really intend to do is, after sitting down and designing and identifying the relevant resource persons who we think will have to come from, even some of them will come from the environment. For example, we can get artisans, we can get painters, we can get, you know, people who can draw from within the community, not necessarily from educational institutions who may be asking for money, within the community to come and help to equip teachers with basic skills in drawing, basic skills in painting, basic skills in the construction of common, you know, primary teaching learning aids. So we're going to get some of the resources from our environment. We're going to solicit support from established educational institutions, teacher training institutions that are found in our environment, so that they can come. And together, we'll be able to run a program. Of course, what we intend to do is to start it in a modest way, identifying a few schools. And I'm using the term few with very much, with respect to the fact that few is relative to our situation, our various situation. We'll identify a few schools, use those teachers in those schools. At the end of the day, we'll see, have we made progress by way of, you know, assessment? We'll use questionnaire, we'll use interviews, we'll use observation. Have we made progress in the few schools that we have identified, the few teachers that we have trained? If yes, what was the source of our success? If no, what were the lapses? So that we'll see what is the next step forward. And at this moment, I would like us to conclude. I would like to conclude our presentation by asking my colleague Lynette, who also belongs to the group, to give us the concluding part.
Thank you very much, Primus. Ladies and gentlemen, finally, we are very much grateful for your keen attention this morning. As we all now agree that teaching can be made very interesting when you add teaching and learning materials inside the classroom, it will cheer up the students, because what I hear, I forget. What I see, I may remember. But what I do, I always understand. Come on, let's go for it. Thank you.
Thank you very much.